This is Herman Brooks. Herman is just like the rest of us. Every day, he has to make all kinds of decisions. Like what to wear, whom to date, and when to panic. Now, these decisions should be easy. But if you take a look inside Herman's head, you'll see why he sometimes has trouble making up his mind.
I'm Herman's intellect. Without me, he couldn't hold his job, pay his rent, or tie his shoes.
I'm Herman's sensitivity. Without me, he wouldn't feel tenderness, honesty, or love. The good things in life.
Oh, I'm Herman's anxiety, and I keep him out of trouble. And believe me, there's trouble everywhere.
I'm Herman's lust. Without me, he'd miss out on all the good stuff. You know, fun, food, babes.
Sometimes they agree. Usually they don't. But this struggle is going on inside all of us. And it's all going on inside Herman's head.
Morning, Mr. Crawford.
People, pay attention. We're in a crowd here, and Mr. Crawford, our senior editor, is standing directly in front of us.
Leave me alone. I'm tired, I'm hungry, and thanks to this idiot, there's no time for breakfast.
I didn't want to be late. Being late upsets me, like New York upsets me. The subways, the homeless, the muggings, the stench.
Wake me up when you get to the hookers.
I'm homesick. I miss Ohio. I miss Mom. I miss Dad. I miss Pokey the parakeet.
Parakeet's been dead for 10 years.
And you don't find that sad?
I'll tell you what's sad. Breaking a date for 3 weeks in a row with Sally Cooper just so we could bring home some extra work. Now that's sad.
In my opinion, Sally Cooper is a slut.
We share that opinion.
People, please focus. Remember, Crawford has the power to hire, fire, and promote. So, let's say something a little pithy, shall we?
Whatever we do, it's going to have to wait, because first we're going to sneeze.
In front of all these people?
Excuse me, Mr. Crawford.
Hey, Hermie.
Morning, Mr. Crawford. Little something on the back of your jacket today, sir.
Herman?
Morning, Mr. Bracken.
Research, what do you need? Moses and the Ten Plagues?
Hold on.
Blood, frogs, flies, lice, pestilence, boil, hail, locust, darkness, and death.
Boy, you sure know your plagues, Mr. Bracken.
My mother's Jewish. Louise, I want references on everything that's underlined.
Yes, sir.
And find out what smells in here.
Yes, sir.
Morning, Louise.
Oh, morning, Herman.
What is that smell?
I think it's me. I was researching an article that said men are sexually attracted by these chemicals called pheromones. So I bought this new perfume with sheep pheromones. What do you think? Do I smell like a wild woman?
Wild is a good word. Gamey is another.
I'll take gamey. Thanks, Herman.
Good morning, Hetty.
Good morning, Herman. Oh, I see you're wearing your other shirt. Why, Louise, new perfume, or are you dating a shepherd? Oh, you're dating a shepherd.
I'm sorry. Did I just say spanking? I meant space. Maybe Jay just needs a little space.
You know what, Herman? I ought to go out and have an affair myself. I'll just go out and find the first man I see, rip his clothes off, and give him the night of his life. Oh. What do you think?
I think we get this girl some booze.
How about a glass of wine?
Thanks. Oh, Herman, I don't know if I really have it in me to have an affair.
Maybe wine's not such a good idea.
On the other hand, the thought of vengeful, unbridled sex really does excite me.
No, what the heck, a little wine never hurt anyone.
On the other hand, I really don't want to hurt Jay.
Look, honey, I don't think an affair is really the best idea.
Having an affair is a great idea.
She's vulnerable. She's in pain. She'll do anything.
I know.
Oh. Wait a minute. What are we doing here? We have got to get our work done. This is our chance to impress Crawford.
The wuss here makes an excellent point. Just the one.
All right. If we're going to dump her, let's dump her gently.
Okay. When she's on her way out, let's look at her butt.
Listen, Connie, I'm sure you're going to feel a lot better about this. Just why don't you just go home and sleep on it?
You're right. Thanks, Herman. Hey, would you like to go out and have dinner tomorrow night?
Tomorrow? Yeah, sure. Tomorrow is great.
Great. It'd be all right if we just talk a little more.
Oh,
you are so sweet. You know, when I first met Jay and we started going out, I thought this is the kind of man I can really open up to. This is the kind of man I could spend the rest of my life with.
Research. That's what it says here. The average time for sex for humans is 2 minutes. Yes, that's with a partner.
Palmer, eat your heart out.
This woman is coming here to talk. Where's your dignity, your honor, your sense of decency?
They're in my pants.
Now, honor is something to think about.
I'll give you something to think about. This little fantasy I've been working on for the last 2 days. It goes something like this.
Okay, honey. You like what you see? Here it is, pal. Come and get it.
Yeah! Hold it! Hold it! Has anybody thought about this?
Oh, Herman!
Oh, God! What do you think you're doing? Candles, flowers, dinner? You are disgusting. You are a pig.
Soon to be an unemployed pig.
You know something? You are really a downer. If we ever become impotent, you can take a bow.
This is ridiculous. Just a minute.
Herman, this is so sweet.
We're sweet. Did you hear that?
Yes, perhaps we should say something nice in return.
Good idea. How about take off your dress?
Oh, my God, Mom!
I say take off your dress and you think about Mom? You've got a serious personal problem, pal.
It's the 14th. We forgot. It's Mom's birthday.
Herman, I never knew you cooked. I'm impressed. All this for me.
Well, it's my mother's birthday.
Oh, is she joining us?
I don't think so.
Boy, you cook, you're a great listener, you're intelligent. What don't you do?
We don't tell the truth, that's what we don't do.
We don't score either. I say we nail her.
Look, if we're going to get involved with Connie, there's only one way to handle it. Find the spiritual connection. Treat her with honesty, respect, and sensitivity, and then we nail her.
So anyway, I said if it's freedom you want, it's freedom you can have. Flowers and candles. What are they doing in the garbage? Herman, were these for me?
For you, no. Yes.
Oh, Herman. I don't know what to say.
I'm sorry. I got a little carried away. I stopped thinking of you as a friend and started thinking of you as a woman.
A woman? Why would you think of me as a woman?
I don't know. The hair, the breasts.
Sometimes that happens to men. We can just hold each other.
No, I can do that. Listen, Jay was just here. He was looking for you.
Really? What'd he say?
Well, it seems he feels he...
Made a mistake?
Yes.
And he still loves me?
Yes.
And he wants to talk to me?
Yes.
Oh, Herman.
Listen, you should talk to him, Connie. It's the right thing to do.
You know, you didn't have to tell me all this. You could have waited until after.
It crossed my mind. Morning, everybody.
Shh.
What's the matter?
A really big mistake was found after everything went to print.
I knew it!
And I'm telling you, we don't overlook things like that. If they said your articles were checked, they were checked. Who's supposed to verify the World Anthropologist articles?
I think that was me.
Oh, I knew it'd be you. Clean out your desk, Herbert.
Herman.
Whatever.
Just a second. Herman works harder than anybody else here. I totally trust him. Herman, tell him you checked them.
Would you like fries with your order, sir?
How could he have checked it and let this go? The average weight of a Danish man's testicles is 24 ounces. 24 ounces. He has people walking around Denmark with testicles that weigh a pound and a half.
Maybe that's where the expression Great Dane came from. I'm very sorry.
Testicles? Wait a minute, we checked that.
Wait a minute, I checked that, I did. And I know I did. Here it is. Let's see, Denmark, testicles, 24 grams. It's grams, not ounces. When that article left my desk, it said grams.
You want to hang somebody, Crawford? You hang somebody in printing.
Young man, looks like I owe you an apology.
That's okay, sir. We all make mistakes.
Now, you handled yourself very well under pressure. You're going to make a name for yourself around here, Sherman.
Herman.
Whatever.
The odds of that were staggering. Phenomenal.
Not really. You see, virtue is rewarded in many ways. Our honesty with Connie was paid back by the universe. What do you think, animal?
I think I'm hungry, I'm still horny, and I gotta take a leak.
Thank you for sharing.
Hey, you got a minute?
Sure, what's up?
I just want to let you know that Connie and I got back together.
Oh, that's great, Jay.
Yeah, but I've got competition now, Herm. She was out with this unbelievable guy last night. She said it was the most romantic night of her life.
Really? Of her life?
Yeah, I'm in big trouble. You should have heard her. I'm never gonna live up to this guy. Well, I'll catch you later, man.
Nice going with Crawford, Herman.
You mean Sherman.
Whatever. Do you mind, Hetty? This is kind of personal.
Well, you got lucky, huh?
You could say that. Hi. Hi. Glad I caught you at home. Yeah. I just wanted to tell you that I was sorry about yesterday. Okay, but I just wanted to let you know that I was thinking about you. Happy birthday, Mom.
This Thursday, catch an all-new episode of 90210 Back to School.